Hey guys, it's your boy Coopers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last time off, he picked up wins in the league over Villa and Stoke. In this episode, I have the quarterfinal of the Capital One Cup against Manchester City, and then I will be playing against Newcastle. And yes, I do remember what happened in real life, if I'll be getting revenge for that. Which is why the title of this video is probably going to be something like Revenge Against the Geordies, or Revenge on the Geordies, or something like that. Something that is probably not very witty, but it'll make sense when I beat them. But first, Manchester City, and the fact that they stand in the way of me retaining the Capital One Cup. So let's take these fuckers down. This is my second team. Even with a few changes, Ojo, who I recall from his loan at Middlesbrough because he'd only played like three goddamn games. I've recalled him. And I'm going to look to loan him back out in January, but I will not be loaning players to Middlesbrough again, because that's obviously a bad idea, because they won't fucking play them. But since he's here, he may as well show me what he can do right now. So I know how to better use him when he is up to that standard. We're currently 67 rated, I think he is. So, you know, a few ratings lower than Jordan Ibe, who he's replaced in the secondary team for this match. Actually, Ibe is on the bench. And their changes are Otazel is in, and Neves is in. So, strong team. And I did play Tielemans in a previous episode, so you know he won't mind missing this game. You know, there is more cup games coming up, especially with FA Cup starting next month. And I might be looking for a new striker. Daniel Sturridge handed in a transfer request. You know, sudden as it is, very disappointed. I'll be looking at a new striker in January. Very disappointed that this has happened. You know, it's just one of those things, though. As much as I'd like to keep him, I just know if he don't try and sell him, the board will sell him. So I may as well. I accepted his wishes and I put him on the wheel. It breaks my heart, but there's not really anything I can do. So, you know, I may even look to include him in whatever deals I do in January. I don't know. I haven't decided who I'm going to go for yet. I'm looking at a lot of options of, you know, players who I could play up front and with deadly accuracy. And I may even show you the list at the end of this episode, but first, let's focus on this episode. Taking the lead there through Otazel. Well, he scored a few goals since I signed him from Bayer Leverkusen, so making himself very worth the $18 million it cost to bring him here to England. And definitely a very effective cam. One thought he would be, an amazing CDM. He seems like he's more attacking style. Really. You know, he's very good on the ball. Over, he's solid. And you know, it's just an amazing all-round play. I have so many good rotational players that if Hopefully not, but if something did happen to one of my starting lineup players, I'd have no problem playing any of the players, which is probably got you guys saying, why don't you just play some one of your younger players up front instead of signing someone new? I could do that. Actually, that'd probably be better. We'll see. Yeah. I was thinking I could just use Daniel Sturridge and a trade offer since he wants to leave anyway. Actually, I don't know why this is the... Although, it would seriously hamper my this team, because I'd have to either change the formation or get another backup striker, because I think I don't know where I'll release him or I'll sell him, but Luis Alberto is probably going to be gone after the January transfer window. He's just not... I wanted to give him a chance, but he's terrible. Oh, you know, the same, he is playing as bad as his Correa was last season when I dropped him for Origi, who just scored there. And it took Correa all the way until the start of the preseason of this season to get back into the team. And I don't, you know, I wasn't too sure on whether to give Alberto that chance or not. I gave him that chance, and, you know, he's not been playing the best, you know. The team's been playing good, but he's not been playing good, you know. Same reason I got rid of Benteke. He really, you know, he just wasn't the right player. Now, all Liverpool need to do in real life is get rid of the real Benteke, because he's terrible. Oh, and shouldn't be wearing a Liverpool shirt. But I digress. We'll sort that stuff out in January. We have a few games to win between now and then. And with West Brom tomorrow. So, focus on that. Get 3 points from the baggies, and yeah, and when January comes around, then we can focus on new players. Good block there by Thiago Elori from Fernandinho's shot. They've done, I've not done what they've done the past two times I play, past times I've played them. When I played them last season and earlier this season, they brought on Sterling late in the game. Wonder if they'll bring him on again in this match. It was a nice yellow card for Kolarov if they hacked down Kamano. Azari. Decision is a throw. It was a fair tackle. There's Shilio. Well, that didn't go as planned. That cross actually was very disappointing. He's got support here. Rigi. Trying to get past Mangala here. Kamano whips it in. Ah, oh, Tazel. He didn't get there first. Anyways. Scuglio. Look at the young Italian go. Rigi! Tried the fancy. Didn't work. Damn it. Yeah, yeah. Collar off. And he lets that go out for Mancy Trovery. Yeah, very clever from Kolarov. And again. No, he fucking wins a trophy for me. Oh, Mangala's made a huge mistake. Ings is away. Hey, Danny Ings against Joe Hart. Oh, Hart, you lucky son of a bitch. Oh, they're not bringing on Sterling. They're bringing on Boney. Hey. Makes me wonder why you didn't start Boney. See? I'm sure Pellegrini has his reasons. Compliments to the drainage at this stadium because the rain was quite heavy earlier in the day. Yeah, well, they've got a good Nasri, he gets the ball off me because I ran right into him like an idiot. Ings. Play that to Ojo. Whips that in. Origi! He. Yes! See? That's what he can do. Oh, if you play him, Mills, brah. Fuck you and fuck everything your team stands for. I loan you one of my star young talents, and I expect him to get a game time. Hemer. That's the whole point of a loan. I don't loan backup players. I expect the players to play. Which is why they should add it in that no matter where the player goes, you can judge whether they're being played or not. Like, I can only track players if they're playing in a European competition or in one of the cups if they don't go to another Premier League club. So yeah, Mish. He'd take a closer look at that for FIFA 17. Allow me to see whether the player is being played or not, and that way I can end his when now he's not wasting his time just sitting around doing nothing. EA Sim. Or simple adjustments. That's all we ask. Make huge improvements to this year's career mode. If you can make similar adjustments in the fact that I can actually see what my players are doing alone, where they're sitting on their ass doing nothing or actually playing, that would be a huge help. In any event, a 3-0 win over Manchester City. He puts me comfortably through to the semi-final while joining Southampton, Chelsea, and Swansea. Tournament prize money. Looking at maybe extending my lead in the league as well. Already 16 points clear of Arsenal. Was make sure I'm keeping up to date on their scoreline. Don't care about what Chelsea and United are doing. It's Arsenal who are the closest to me. Looks like it's going to be snowing in this game. Which is going to be a pain in the ass. Yep, there it is. There's the snow. Welcome to this always intriguing game, but it might have another element to it today. I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith, I'll pose that question to you. What about the snow? Yes, it's coming down quite heavily at the moment. I'm not sure whether that's going to continue, but it can be a problem for the players actually to see the ball. The old orange ball might be out before long. This is the Liverpool side. Nathaniel Klein starts with Ricardo Rodriguez in the fullback positions. I'm not sure what that was about. Random back pass. That's almost a confusion at the back. Royce! Oh, an easy goal for Marco Royce. He slots it home. And he could have easily done that with his eyes closed. Look at that. Shoddy defending from, I think it was Mbemba. You can see a slightly different viewpoint on it. Doesn't help, I can't see his number. Yeah, it is Mbemba. And Tim Krul, well, despite being a good keeper, can't really keep that out, can he? 10th goal of the season for Marco Reus. He's quickly climbing up that goal scorer rankings quickly. He's Reus now has the same amount of goals he scored all last season. So both my both Royce and Coutinho are doing much better than they did in season one. I think they may have taken Henderson's goals because he's not scoring as many as he did last season. And Correa scores this, you know, after a bit of a drought, just a small one. That's his 10th goal as well. His goals had dried up a little bit, you know, nothing to worry about just yet. It's nothing I'd drop him over just yet. We haven't got to that point yet. We're still winning, we're still on top of the table, undefeated, only conceded 2 goals. Life is pretty good right now. Oh, we'll be completely honest. And already 2-0 up in this match. See, that's what, you know, that's the miracle that you can do when you actually play good strikers instead of playing a big-ass useless Belgian. I mean, seriously, Sturridge got injured. If he was going to get injured, he may as well have played the whole fucking game and actually... He impacted on the scoreline. No, instead he came on in the 60th minute. It's way too late. Hey! I didn't actually know you could do that. Freaking, Krul will bait the ball straight into Bale. Surprised that wasn't a foul. I don't know if you can give that as a foul, to be honest. Legal about it. So we've been here from Royce. Bale! Ooh, good save by Krul. Krul is keeping Newcastle in this by keeping it still at 2-0. There's Verein. Here's the top goal scorer in the whole Premier League. That's a foul there by Haidara. Thank you. Free running over, of course, to spray his magic spray. Royce, ooh, had a second pop at it. Gave Krul much more to deal with than the initial free kick. Laporte, very bad header from the from one of my two French center backs. Sturridge, track, brilliant. the Dutchman is having no troubles with these attempted world being shots. Trying to score something special. Bale! Ooh! Coutinho. I was just about to say, is that not a foul there by, yeah, by callback? Looking for Royce. It's gotten away eventually. In the end, it was Yanma who got it away. There won't be a troll because it's half time. Holy shit, Watford are beating Arsenal! Oh my god, if Arsenal lose, they will draw. Oh my. Yo, I'm winning the league and seriously, no one's seemingly trying to stop me. Yeah, I'm practically running away with it, and I'm doing very little. Yes, I've already beaten Arsenal, but that's one game. They're currently losing to Watford. Imagine if Watford beat Arsenal. Watford would gain a lot of respect here. Oh, Sturridge. It's a bit of a mistake there by Jesus. Oh, you lucky fuckers. Krul with the amazing double save. Somehow kept it at 2-0. Well, because reasons. Bale might still make it 3. No, he was judged to have fouled. Well, was it Goof Run? Yeah, it was Goof Run. Just watching it back. Second. Henderson. Please. Coutinho to Correa. You can give it back to Coutinho. Go for another goal. Philippe Coutinho. Of course he's gonna score in this episode. He is scoring for fun this season. And the Brazil and Argentinian connection between him and Correa. Didn't need the help of the Englishman to beat the Dutch keeper. And everyone's just standing and watching it go in. And apparently, the defenders decide not to do their job. And after countless goals he prevents, Tim Krul cannot prevent it anymore. It is 3-0. Oh, another foul on Gouffran. My players must not like Gouffran very much. They seem to be following him and only him. Even though I'm not telling them to follow him.
Well, that's very good positional play, and he's read the situation perfectly with that interception.
Overton. Wait, does Overton even still play for Newcastle? I thought he left Newcastle. Could be confusing that with somebody else. Probably am. My mistake if I am. Oh, what a ball to Correa! If he can keep that in, yes. Yes. Interesting pass. As I chose there. Or I might have accidentally let Jose Perez in. They still have the ball. Oh, sure. Yes. Nothing to worry about, really. Versus gonna outpace Yamat. Mauricio, they're all over him. God damn it. I couldn't get away from Yamat. He was containing like a boss. Ooh. The big game for Newcastle is next. I have Swansea on New Year's Eve, on Christmas Eve. And, Newcastle will be playing Sunderland. Hopefully they don't get the bullshit that they got in real life. Henderson! Oh, Jordan Henderson! Speaking of Sunderland, actually, former Sunderland player, scores against Newcastle. Oh. Powers it into the top corner. I was just saying that he hadn't scored as many as he did last season. But out of the blue, boom, he rockets it into the top corner. For what is probably like only his second or third goal. Ooh. Yeah, it's only his second goal of the season. Not as many as last season, but last season we will remember. Or, oh, we have video proof that you were amazing last season. And, you know, still amazing. He's putting in all the effort you do. Jordan Henderson, top class player. Here comes Sissoko for Newcastle. Not sure what Sissoko can do for Newcastle 4-0 down. I mean, they took off a defensive player for an attacking player. I mean, maybe they're going for... Maybe their thought is, right, we're not going to win this, so let's go for a consolation goal. Coutinho! Oh, wow! I did not expect that to go in. I just hit it. And Philippe Coutinho. Oh, that little Brazilian magician does it again. And there was a callback who gave the ball to Coutinho. Well, the pass was short. I think it was intended for Sissoko. And the shot... I'm sure Crew will be wondering how it beat him. I'm kind of wondering how it beat him. 16th goal of the season. Second of the match. Philippe Coutinho. It doesn't help me for most making mistakes at every turn. They're lucky who got that ball. Hey, and I didn't get that her first. But in the end, it is a 5-0 win. The revenge is complete. Marco Reus gets a 9.1. Goal and assist. I would have given it to Coutinho, but that's me. And yes, Watford did beat Arsenal. Although Chelsea beat Everton. And so Chelsea should be second. Yeah, they are. But now the ball is completely out of Arsenal's court. And now Watford are fourth in the table. Oh. Well, are Watford doing what Leicester are doing in real life? You know, shockingly breaking into the top four? Although, a little bit different because Leicester are top of the table and Watford are fourth. But, you know, a little bit similar. A little bit. Not completely, but a little bit. Should be interesting to see how well they can do. Maybe he Watford will pull off a shock and qualify themselves for the Champions League next season. Who knows? All I know is I am 17 points clear of the next team, which is Chelsea. In the next episode, he will be playing in the games against Swansea, Sheffield Wednesday, and Watford. And then we'll be into the January transfer window of 2017. Until the next episode, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you.